I want to discuss why fasting can help lower your blood pressure. High blood pressure or hypertension usually has no symptoms. You don't know what's going on unless you get your blood pressure tested. And if you're getting older, it might be a good idea to have a blood pressure cuff around just to assess this. There's two types of hypertension. You have primary and you have secondary. 95% of all hypertension cases are primary, okay, hypertension. And that's related to lifestyle. And so if you look this up, they're going to mention, you know, consuming too much salt, having obesity, smoking, drinking alcohol. The recommendation is consuming a healthy diet. I love it. But if you dig further into what they recommend as a healthy diet, that's where you get the problem, because they're recommending fruits, vegetables, whole grains. You have to stick the whole grains in there. Less than 30% of your calories being fat. And of course, they recommend avoiding the saturated fats, of course. And then they recommend less than 10% simple sugars. So they're allowing up to 10% of all your calories being simple sugars. Wow, amazing. Well, what does that come out to in teaspoons? 12 teaspoons a day. Okay, that's 50 grams of sugar. That's what they're allowing. Okay, that's considered part of a healthy diet. Now, before I say anything else, I want to give a disclaimer. I'm not recommending you coming off your medication without the help of your doctor, okay? Just giving you data to think with. So there was a study called the Sprint Trial Study in 2015 where they tested people over 50 years old with high blood pressure, and they found that they lived a little bit longer when they took multiple medications for hypertension, okay? That sounds pretty good, but here's the problem with that. They found significant risks with this benefit of living longer. And that risk is a significant increased risk in kidney disease. Okay? And so if something can help you, yet it comes with this other thing that can hurt you, it's not the ideal situation from my viewpoint. Now, the other interesting thing about this study is they didn't use everyone that had high blood pressure. They only used a fraction of the people that had high blood pressure in their pool of people that they were using, the ones that were the most severe. And so if you don't have a severe high blood pressure problem, then this data on it helping you live longer would be invalid because they didn't test those people. Shifting gears, there was another study on 174 individuals who did fasting. And yes, it was medically supervised, but there was a 90% success rate of lowering blood pressure into a fairly good range when people did fasting. But my question is why? Well, this is why. Because fasting is the most powerful way to lower insulin. And when you have high insulin, because you have insulin resistance, the arteries become very, very stiff. And so one of the root causes of hypertension is a blood sugar problem coming and being caused by insulin resistance and high levels of insulin. But the high levels of insulin that should normally lower the blood sugars is not working because of the insulin resistance. The point is this: if you have insulin resistance, you're at risk of getting hypertension. And this is why people that have the metabolic syndrome, syndrome X, one part of that is hypertension. And the common thread with that condition is high levels of insulin, hyperinsulinemia. Okay, that's the medical term, but it's basically just insulin resistance. All right, so what should you do if you have high blood pressure? Start fasting immediately. Start doing intermittent fasting. That right there might just totally handle it. And then you can get with your doctor and work together to wean off your medication. All right, number two, add vitamin D. Vitamin D is a very powerful natural remedy for high blood pressure. Next point is potassium. Start taking more potassium. If you're low in potassium, your arteries can get very stiff. So potassium makes the arteries very, very soft and flexible. I put a link down below with other benefits from potassium. All right, add vitamin K2. Why? Because vitamin K2 helps remove excess calcium from the arteries. Okay, so it's going to make the arteries more pliable, elastic, because calcium tends to make them more rigid. Vitamin D and K2 work together. This is why one of the remedies for hypertension is calcium channel blockers. Why are they blocking calcium? Because the calcium is making things very, very stiff. And vitamin K2 can help counter that. And then add magnesium. Ideally, you should get your magnesium and potassium from leafy greens, large amounts of salad, but you can also add magnesium to your diet, like magnesium orotate is a really good one, and watch your blood pressure come down. But those are all the nutritional things that can help you. But if you add fasting and a low-carb diet, which will also help insulin resistance, I think that would be a really good plan to avoid high blood pressure. And I just want to mention this point. When doing research on this topic, it's just amazing how much data that is put out there on the front page of Google. In fact, it's not just on the first page on Google. It's on the first five pages of Google, all the links. It's just you get all this data, all this information. What I try to communicate in the videos, all the videos that I do, is the important stuff, not the trivial stuff. So when you're doing research in the area of health problems and many other things, you have to dig through all the fluff, all the minutiae, all the trivial stuff to find the gold. And so I just want to let you know that I spent a lot of time in focusing on this one point, is just giving you the most important stuff and not the trivial. All right. Thanks for watching. Hey, before you go real quick, I have a course entitled How to Bulletproof Your Immune System. It's a free course. I want you to take it. And here's why. Here's you. Here is your environment. Everyone is focused on this over here, avoiding your environment. But what about here? What about strengthening your immune system? That's what's missing. This course will show you how to bulletproof yourself. And so you can tolerate and resist your environment much better by strengthening your own immune system. I put a link down in the description right down below. Check it out and get signed up today.